Ubuntu 25.10 Questing Quokka releases not far, and we have a clear picture of what we are getting in this new version, including radical new changes like Rust-based sudo. Let's have a look at all the major new features in this video. Ubuntu 25.10 now provides a modern new feature of TPM-backed full disk encryption. Actually, it was already there in previous version, but 25.10 has improvements. Now you get two options. TPM-only, where your PC just unlocks itself without additional trouble, or TPM plus passphrase, which means you will have to enter your password every time, which adds an additional security layer. If you go with TPM plus passphrase, you are given a recovery key. Now, you cannot save the recovery key in a live session, so either you plug in an additional external disk or you save the recovery key by taking a photo of the QR code. Now, don't try to take the photo of my recovery code shown here. It's just a temporary virtual machine and will be deleted even before 25.10 is released. Okay, why recovery key? So at boot, if you do not enter the TPM passphrase within a time frame, you will have to enter the recovery key. So this is why you have to save your recovery key. And this is for people with shiny new laptops that has hardware-based encryption in the form of TPM. If you're still rocking an older machine, you can stick with LUKS-based encryption or even skip disk encryption altogether. The other noticeable change is the new default terminal called TISIS or SISIS or PTYSIS. I don't know how to pronounce it. As if terminal was not complicated for beginners enough that they come up with this tongue twister of a name. Now, this weird sounding terminal comes up with some wonderful features. The foremost being container integration. So if your workflow involves dealing with containers, you will love it. It automatically detects container on your system and allows you to just enter them by selecting them from the dropdown. I showed this clipping from my Fedora installation because this terminal that cannot be named has been the default since Fedora 41. Fedora leads the way, it seems. Okay, so this wonderful container integration feature works with Podman, DistroBox, Toolbox, except Docker, which is a big miss because Docker is like the de facto container management system. Boo. Okay, there's also an inspect terminal feature, which is sort of like those inspect features developers use in web browsers. Only here, it provides details on running command line tools. Anyways, if you're not into containers and development, no worries. You get a modern interface and plenty of built-in themes to choose from. And that's a good enough change for the new default terminal. Speaking of new defaults, there is another change in the default programs. Ubuntu 25.10 has a new default image viewer in the form of loop or loupe. I don't know. I'm getting weirdly intimidated by these strange pronunciation, as if my accent was not torturous enough for you already. All right, this new image viewer packs some new features. It has GPU-accelerated image rendering for SVGs, it supports more than 15 image formats by default, and above all, it allows you to crop, rotate, and flip the images. So basic editing options as long as these images are in PNG or JPEG format. The interface is modern and touch-friendly, so it's a welcome change. Speaking of welcome changes, there is one more default change that may not be as welcome as the other two, or probably it is. Our beloved sudo is being replaced with a Rust implementation sudo rs, which is more memory safe and less buggy, or so they say. Now, for the end users like you and me, it doesn't change us anything as we will still be typing sudo. But underneath, sudo is soft linked to sudo rs. There are hardly any visual changes except perhaps a few warning messages. Nothing to be worried about if you are a regular user. However, if you are a sysadmin with custom sudo configurations, you should start paying attention as some features have been changed. features like send mail support, wildcard arguments in command specs, LDAP configuration storage are no longer here. For now, you can use the classic sudo as sudo ws and even make it the default sudo again. But starting with Ubuntu 26.10, the OG sudo won't be existing anymore. So prepare for the inevitable. Next feature, or the lack of it, is the removal of the classic xorg session in favor of Wayland. Earlier, you had the option to switch to the X display from the login screen. Not anymore. The Wayland future is now xorg man. Let's see some less disrupting changes now. GNOME 49 brings in a couple of new features, like more granular control over the permissions of an application from the system settings. You can also add applications to run automatically at boot from here. Another one is the inclusion of media control buttons on the lock screen. So now you can control the music on your computer without having to unlock it. Ubuntu 25.10 also adds a few new icons and refreshes some old ones. It is hardly a noticeable change. Another change that you probably won't notice again is Ubuntu Insights tool that supplants Ubuntu Report for transparent consent-based non-personally identifiable system info and metrics collection, basically the telemetry. What you will actually notice is the new set of wallpapers. I know, not a groundbreaking change, but it's always good to look at them, especially the new default one with the mascot. Ubuntu 25.10 Questing Quokka will have latest kernel 6.17, which should mean support for newer hardware, including Snapdragon X Elite. Remember that it is a short-term release that will be supported for 9 months only. So if you are running Ubuntu 24.04 LTS, you need a fresh install of 25.10, and I would advise against it. You are better off with the next LTS coming in 2026. And if you were using 25.04, well, you should upgrade it when it is released. The release may still be a month away, but these are the main feature changes that we should be getting. Over to you now to share your most liked and disliked feature in Ubuntu 25.10. And anyone commenting, by the way, I use Arch Linux, will be sent Ubuntu 25.10 ISO download link. I'm not kidding. I am. Or maybe not.